So we're still looking at our retro synthetic analysis, right? We're asking our three main questions. Let's go ahead and just do another example here. So we're going to go from this alcohol over here to this component over here, this aldehyde, right? And so the number one question we want to ask ourselves is, did the number of carbons change? And so I'm just going to look at this substituent off the cyclohexane. We've got two carbons here. We've only got one carbon here. And so the answer to this question is yes, we have less carbons. And so that must be some kind of oxidative cleavage. And if we think about the functional groups that we have for our question number two, right? What kind of functional groups do we have, right? We went from an alcohol all the way to some kind of aldehyde. So yes, they did change. Right, we haven't learned a one-step way to do this, but to get to an aldehyde and have less carbons, we had to have done some kind of oxidative cleavage. And so that means ozone with zinc, right? That's the only way we can make an aldehyde through oxidative cleavage. And so applying that retrosynthetic analysis, right, that must have meant that we cleaved right here, which means that the previous reaction or the previous component was this alkene right over here. And we added O3 and zinc to it, right? Now we have to figure out how are we going to get from one of these components to another one. And so over here, we have this alcohol, right? There's different things that we learned how to do alcohols with. One is a dehydrogenation, but if you think about the mechanism there, that's going to form the more substituted alkene, whereas here we want the less substituted alkene. And so we need to either get rid of this alcohol somehow or transform it into a better component, a better leaving group. And in order to make alcohols into better leaving groups, you can add some tosyl chloride and some pyridine. Right, so we've got this OTS group. And then we're thinking about, is there any way we can connect this alkene to this OTS? There is indeed. We've learned how to do this. We just need some kind of bulky base to do an E2 reaction, right? So that way we can get the Hoffman product. And so something like DBU, right? And so you can see how you can analyze these things by asking some simple questions and then working backwards, but also working forwards and trying to meet somewhere in the middle.